We all know that rules are not created in a vacuum based on academically what's the right answer. There's political pressures, and I'm sure that you had political pressures exerted upon you. So why don't you share with us, you know, how those political pressures are applied and how do we respond to them in our profession?
You know, it's the world used to be so simple. And I think back when, Tim, you and I went to school, there were much less rules involved. There was more conceptual framework. And actually, the International Financial Reporting Rules, the IFRS rules that are being promulgated, there's 92 countries that require IFRS, International Financial Reporting Standards. Those countries, and there's about 123 countries that allow international financial reporting standards. You know, when I look at it, when I look in terms of political pressures, there's the global pressures, then there's the national pressures, then there's the pressures of within the profession, and there's individual pressures. So I guess the challenges within the global side, Sir David Tweedy, who was the chair of the International Standards Board, he just retired in June, and he was very patient over the years that the United States has not adopted international financial reporting standards. Hans Hoogeverst is the new chairman, and he's saying, you know, if we want a seat at the table, we really should adopt. And the SEC, and this is where some of the pressure points are, the SEC had provided a roadmap several years ago that by now we really should have been well on our way to international financial reporting standards. Well, we have not adopted those. The SEC certainly had some other things over the last several years to be focused on, not the least of the economic crisis, but that's kind of delayed that process. So we have pressures from the international side, we have pressures from the SEC, we've got pressures from the FASB and the FAF, and I'll go into one of those with private company financial reporting standards also, but so those kind of pushbacks, that political pressure that you see, it sometimes is healthy. Sometimes things are before their time, and certainly our accounting standards, the generally accepted accounting standards and accounting principles are thought to be sometimes, you know, the best in the world, but we are very rules-based, and as opposed to international financial reporting standards, is conceptual-based. And so, you know, we've got some liability issues here with the United States where we've got a very litigious society where other countries don't have to deal with that. So it's that political pressure is good for political discussion. It's good for push and pull every once in a while. We as an institute generally get along with our regulators. We generally get along, although sometimes we do have pushback, and I've seen that a number of times. We will issue letters to say, you know, we don't see this as comment letters, that this is not the right direction. But generally, overall, we balance it out. Now, on the private company financial reporting standards, I mentioned that was one of the things that I felt very proud of. We're not there yet. And part of it is making sure that we do generate those correct private company financial reporting standards. And so we're debating that back and forth with FASB and FAF. So those are just some of the areas.